स्टूडेंट्स इन अवर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस बृहन मुंबई महानगर पालिका शिक्षण विभाग ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन इंग्लिश मीडियम क्लास फिफ्थ सब्जेक्ट EVS 2 मायसेल्फ सुवर्णा वनाजी खरोटे फ्रॉम गोखले रोड साउथ म्युनिसिपल इंग्लिश स्कूल दादर वेस्ट. अवर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव ऑफिसर इज मिसेस स्नेहलता डुमरे मैडम. अवर नोडल बीट ऑफिसर शरद कुराड़े सर. नोडल HM मिसेस पुष्पा मैरी पॉल. असिस्टेंट नोडल HM मिसेस मनप्रीत कौर. टुडेज थॉट ऑफ द डे इज द की टू सक्सेस इज टू फोकस ऑन गोल्स नॉट ऑब्स्टेकल्स. मीन्स समटाइम्स व्हेन वी ट्राई टू अचीव अवर गोल्स वी हैव टू गो थ्रू अ लॉट ऑफ इश्यूज एंड ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम अवर फोकस शिफ्टेड टू दोज ऑब्स्टेकल्स. So when we shift our focus to constraints, it becomes harder for us to achieve our goals. So the key to success is to focus on goals, not obstacles. Class 5, subject EVS 2, topic C, chapter 6, Stone Age and Stone Tools. Let's see. We are going to learn in this topic types of forms of tools according to the type of task, stone age and stone tools. Students, observe this picture and tell me, do you observe your mother while she is working in kitchen? Yes, students. Do you observe your mother while she is working in kitchen?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, very good. Do you help her?
Yes.
Okay, very nice. What will you use to cut the vegetables then?
I'm helping my mother to cut the vegetable and wash the vegetable.
Yes, very good, very good. And what will you use to cut the vegetable?
Knife.
Knife, very nice, very nice. And do you like to do craft work?
Yes.
Very good. What will you use to cut the paper?
Scissor.
Scissor. Very nice. Now, observe this picture carefully and tell me for what purpose these tools are used. These are hardware tools used by carpenter, electrician. No? There is hammer and lots of work we can do with the help of these tools. Similarly, Stone Age man to use different tools which were made of stones and later metals. So today we are going to learn particularly about Stone Age and stone tools. See, observe this picture and tell me if you saw a shiny object buried in the ground, what would we do to take it out? See, one shiny object is there in the picture. See, perhaps we would scrape out with our fingers. If that did not work, we might try to dig it out with a twig or stick. If that too do not work, then what would have to look? Too did not work, then for pointed stone, we are searching here and there. Then that should do the job. But if it still doesn't, then we would have to get an iron rod to dig that shiny object out. This shows that we need to choose the tool according to the demand of the task. So, demand of the task is more important. The following four factors determine our choice of tools. First one is availability of resources. Second one, minimal use of time and energy. And third one, maximum efficiency. And fourth one, skill of handling tools, which is acquired through practice. In last activities, I shows you that we need to choose the tool according to the demand of the task, no? Yes. Now, observe this picture. Apis are there, no? Can you see these apis like the chimpanzee? Yes, apis like the chimpanzee also use the stone to break seeds and nuts. They use the stick to steer the ants out from anthills. To catch them, humans too have always been using tools such as a bone, stones, dry twigs and sticks as tools. Now, types and forms of tools according to the type of task with continuous and minute observation, experimentation, and their inborn imagination, humans learned that they could sharpen the rods, bones, sticks, and stones into tools to carry out their tasks more efficiently. Now see, in this picture, the tools made from the stones and bones. First one is a chopper made from the pebble. You know the pebble? It's a big stone in round shape. Okay? Then second one is a, yes, tell me the name. There is given the name in the chart. Second picture is a scraper. Third one, you can see a circular hammer stone. Then fourth, a chopper. This chopper is made from a flax of stone. And fifth one is a borer made from a bone. And sixth, an antler use a pick. These tools made by the humans thousands of years ago, only the stone tools can be found today. Tools made from bone are rarely found, but since twigs and sticks decompose easily, we do not find any tools made from them. See, in this picture, tools made by the humans thousands years ago, only the stone tools can be found today. But since twigs and sticks decompose easily, na? So we do not find any tools made from them. See, what is called the Stone Age? Here is given the period from which mainly stone tools are found is called the Stone Age. The period from which mainly stone tools are found is called the Stone Age. The Stone Age is divided into three periods on the basis of the shape and the types of the tools found. First one is the Old Stone Age, second one Middle Stone Age, third one New Stone Age. Old Stone Age means the Paleolithic Age. Paleo means the old. Lithos means the stone. So Old Stone Age or Paleolithic Age, this is first one. Second one, Middle Stone Age, is called also the Mesolithic Age. Meso means middle. Then third one is a New Stone Age or a Neolithic Age. Neo means new Stone Age. Let's see, Old Stone Age, Paleolithic Age. See, Homo habilis and Homo erectus, who belongs to the Old Stone Age, made their tools using the percussion technique. This technique is beating or strike one large pebble against another to another stone flex. The first tools made in the Old Stone Age with this technique were crude. Only one side of those tools had, and such tools are known as a chopper. See, the Homo habilis and Homo erectus, who belongs to the Stone Age, they sharpened the one side and made their tools using this technique is called the percussion technique. See, in this picture, here are given some of the tools made by the Homo habilis or chopper and flax. they indicates that Homo habilis had not yet learned to hunt, use for breaking nuts or bones, use the flakes for scraping meat from hide, for chopping meat and other foodstuffs, for sharpening wood sticks, etc. Okay, see this picture. Tools like the hand axe. Tool like hand axe and a cleaver made by a Homo erectus. No? Then before Homo erectus, Homo habilis is there. And they are trying to do the chopper. See in this picture, one who uses his hand skillfully and making the chopper, beating one pebble on another stone. Here also, Homo habilis is doing some pebbles chopping on the stone. They adapted to their environments by making a simple tools. How stone tools are made from the stone age human? See, in this first picture, there is given the process started with a large piece of rock. Second one, the human shape the rock with a stone hammer. See the stone hammer. It's a round shape. One edge is continuously beating. Then using a hammer made of a wood, stone, or antler, they sharpen the edges. Then fourth one, they trim the edge by praying off tiny flakes with a pointed stick. The next, finish now hand axe. Front view and side view, you can see in this picture how it looked like. Tools like the hand axe, cleaver made by Homo erectus are more proportionate and symmetrical than the chopper made by Homo habilis. A proportionate and a symmetrical tool has to be mentally visualized first. Only then it is possible to make it. Homo erectus could mentally visualize his tools even before he actually shaped them. To obtain stone flakes, he used things like antlers and hammers. He further sharpened the edges of those flakes by scraping of smaller pieces to make scraper with very sharp edges. It means that Homo erectus was using different tools for different tasks according to the demand of the task. See in this peak. In this peak, the maker of the tools and weapons with the help of the Homo erectus started using the stone weapons. He make a axe and a pickaxe and knife. With his improved tools, Homo erectus could have a great variety of foods now. Given here, with his improved tools, Homo erectus could have a great variety of food because he could not hunt a variety of big and small animals. These included mainly the deer, bison, and rabbit, etc. See, the Homo erectus started the hunting very finely with the help of these tools. Homo sapiens. Now, see, after Homo erectus, Neanderthal man made the further progress in tool making technique and he began to make smaller tools. Then Homo sapiens brought about a revolution in the technique of the making tools. He devised a technique of obtaining long and narrow blades of stone. He made various implements like the knife, scraper, borer, chisel, etc. From these long blades, he also began to use the ivory and rare stones of the quartz variety of making tools and other articles also. And they started to make a hearse made by the Homo sapiens, see, you can see in this picture, Homo sapiens started to make herds and so he likes stone and bones ornaments. They're trying to do this. Then few paintings by Homo sapiens also given in third picture. You can see the children in this picture, cave paintings. Okay, now in next picture, there is given domesticating dogs. See, Homo sapiens in the middle stone age continued to make a progress in many different ways, and agriculture revolution started by the Homo sapiens. He started a new hunting and fishing technique with the help of new hunting and fishing tools. See, Homo sapiens had made the significant progress in gaining the knowledge of his environment and in the techniques of making tools and obtaining foods. This enabled him to stay in one place for a longer period of time. Groups of Homo sapiens had begun to build the herds and live in them. They also had started to celebrating social festivals and many artistic objects. You can objects and cave paintings also. In this picture I shown you now, and created by the Homo sapiens were possibly meant by these festivals. Now, Homo sapiens had started using the ornaments to adore themselves. Beads from the time of the Homo sapiens made of the shells, bones, and animal teeth have been found. Thus, the beginning of the human culture go back to the old stone age. Now, remains of the tools from the old stone age heads have been found in the India at various places, from the Kashmir to Tamil Nadu. However, not many human fossils from the old stone age from being found in India. See, in this picture is given about the middle stone age man. See, many sites of the middle stone age have been found in India. I just told you, among them Bangar in Rajasthan, Bhimtek in Madhya Pradesh, Laghnach in Gujarat, and Patne in Jalgaon district in Maharashtra are the well-known ones. In middle stone age, the stone blades used to make implements were removed from the stone by the fluted core. First peak, observe the first peak, a fluted core. What is meaning of fluted core? What is meaning of flute? Flute means a long parallel sides depression on the stone. And core means the original stone from which the blades are removed. After the removing blade, after that blade removed from the stone, from all the sides, the remaining core had such flutes on all sides. Blades removed from these techniques are a minute. The size is very small, of nail size or slightly bigger. Hence, they are called a microliths. Micro means very small, and lithos means stone. See, you can see in this picture, microliths. What is called the micro? What is called the micro? Means very small. And lithos means stone. In the middle stone age, arrows were made by the fixing these microbes at the tip of the stick. See, in third picture, arrows with the microliths as tips, middle stone age man use this. One stick is there, they fixed the microbes on the tip and it becomes arrow. In fourth picture, see the knife. A knife with the edge like a sauna. In fifth picture, can you tell about fifth picture? Yes, fish hooks. These fish hooks made from the bones. Okay, now next, new stone age. Middle stone age finished. Then next stone age is a Neolithic age. New stone age. New stone age means Neolithic age means new. Okay. In this period, stone tools that were polished to give a smooth, shiny object that finishing gives were made for the first time. As this was a new type of the tool making technique, this period was named the New Stone Age. See in this picture, there are you can see some objects, na? Yes.
Yes.
In this picture, you can see. Can you tell me the names? Can you identify these objects? Yes. Axe is there. Hammer is there. These are very polished object, no? In this period, stone tools that were polished and to give a smooth, shiny finishing. So, like this way, they were made for the first time. So, as this was a new type of tool making technique, this period is called New Stone Age. By this time of New Stone Age, agriculture and domestication of the animals and animals husbandry also developed. See, animal husbandry means what? You know, agriculture and domestication of the animals. Yes. Yes, in routine by this time of the New Stone Age, agriculture and domestication of the animals. Animals are farmers use the animals in their field, na, to become easy their work, harder work become easy, and or the animals husbandry had become a routine way of their life. Now hunting was no more the major means of obtain food. Now it becomes secondary to agriculture and animal husbandry. There are many sites of the New Stone Age culture in the India, especially along the Ganga River in the south. There we can get evidences about New Stone Age. See, with the help of this table, let's discuss with the help of this table, we compare Old Stone Age, Middle Stone Age and New Stone Age. Now discuss with me, students. Tools used in Old Stone Age. Which are tools you can see in first table? Which tools used in Old Stone Age? Yes, chopper, hammer, borer, chisel, scraper, etc. These tools used in Old Stone Age. See, in Middle Stone Age, knife, sickle, these tools used in Middle Stone Age. In New Stone Age, agricultural tools are there. Observe this picture. In Old Stone Age, how is the appearance of these tools? It's very proportionate and symmetrical. And in Middle Stone Age tools, appearance, lightweight, durable tools. And New Stone Age appearance of the tools, smooth and shiny finishing. Now, in third table, we are observing the uses. In Old Stone Age uses for scraping the meat, chopping the meat. We use the chopper for chopping the meat, hammer, borer, chisel, scraper. No? Then in Middle Stone Age, we can see knife, sickle, that pictures, this use. We can observe this picture, tools used for hunting, fishing, harvesting, cutting of trees, etc. Now in third, New Stone Age uses ag for the agriculture purposes. Okay, are you understood, students? This table? Okay, we compare here Old Stone Age, middle stone age and new stone age. The technique used in old stone age, percussion technique. Now just I taught you about the percussion technique. In next middle stone age, fluted core technique. And in third, new stone age is polishing. We can differ the techniques here. Percussion technique in old stone age, fluted core technique in middle stone age, and polishing technique in new stone age. What is called the percussion technique? Are you remember? Just I taught you. This technique involves beating or striking one large paper against another to obtain stone flakes. No, just I taught you, no? Okay. Then fluted core technique. This and polishing technique in the new stone age. In next slide, we can see the changes in man's lifestyle in old stone age, middle stone age, and new stone age. Changes in man's life: stayed in one place, built a herds, and lived in groups, celebrated festivals, used ornaments. In middle stone age, domesticated dogs, sheep, and goats, harvested wild food grains, started eating plant food. And new stone age, agriculture and animal husbandry became a means of obtaining food. Hunting became a secondary. Now, site places where tools were found, where evidences, we get the evidences for the old stone age, middle stone age, and new stone age. See, first, old stone age, near a Gangapur, near a Nashik, Gangapur is there. Chirki in Nevas, near a Nevas. Both are in Maharashtra places. And Afghanistan and Sri Lanka. Then middle stone age, Bengal, Rajasthan. Pimbate, Madhya Pradesh. Anyone can read these? Try the student to read these. Site places where tools were found in middle stone age, Bangor, Rajasthan, Bhimbatek, Madhya Pradesh, Langnaj, Gujarat, Patne in Jalgaon. We are going to see in this map. You can observe the map, old stone age. It's shown in green color, the Maharashtra. In Maharashtra, what I told you, Gangapur near Nasik. See the old stone age. Gangapur in Nasik, Chirki, Nevasa, near the Nevasa, Afghanistan, and Sri Lanka. See here, in second, Afghanistan is there. And Sri Lanka. Okay, can you identify throughout this map? Okay, in middle stone age, Bangor, Rajasthan, Bangor in Rajasthan, Bhimbatek in Madhya Pradesh, Langnaj in Gujarat, Patne in Jalgaon. Observe this. In this map, there is given, shown here, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, and Maharashtra. In New Stone Age, some places are here. River Ganga, South India, New Stone Age. See the map, that blue line indicates the river Ganga, and here down South India is shown. Now next, answer the following questions. Tell me the answer, which period is called the Stone Age? Yes, students, which period is called the Stone Age? Can you tell? See.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, here is given the answer. Yes, the period from which mainly stone tools are found is called the Stone Age. Please repeat after me. Repeat the answer. The period from which mainly stone tools are found is called the Stone Age. Second question is, what are the three types of Stone Age? What are the three types of the Stone Age? Tell me the answer. Now just we I shown you. Here is given the answer. You can see the three periods of Stone Age. First one is the Old Stone Age or Paleolithic Age. Second one is a Middle Stone Age or Mesolithic Age. And third one is a New Stone Age or Neolithic Age. Yes, please you can repeat the three periods of Stone Age, Old Stone Age, Middle Stone Age, and New Stone Age. Old Stone Age means Paleolithic Age, Middle Stone Age means Mesolithic Age, and New Stone Age means Neolithic Age. Now, third question is, tell me the answer, which are human species that belong to the Old Stone Age? Which are human species that belongs to the Old Stone Age? Here is given answer. And Homo erectus. Yes, very good. Homo habilis and Homo erectus are the human species that
suspected that belong to the Old Stone Age.
Yes, very good. Now next question is, what are known as the first tools made by the Old Stone Age man? What are known as the first tools made by the Old Stone Age man? See here, chopper. No? The first tool made by the Old Stone Age man are known as a chopper. Then fifth question, give examples of tools made by Homo erectus. Give examples of tools made by the Homo erectus. Hand axe. Hand axe, no? And cleaver are the examples of tools made by the Homo erectus. Give examples of animals hunted by Homo erectus. Hunted by Homo erectus. Okay. Repeat here. I given here on the slide. Can you repeat? Homo erectus hunted animals like the deer, bison, rabbit, etc. Okay, students, are you understood? Okay, one more time. I'm going to show you table here, device here, tools used in Old Stone Age, in Middle Stone Age, New Stone Age.
Yes, means.
Yes. Can you tell now about which tools used in Old Stone Age? Chopper, hammer, borer, scissors, scraper.
Yes, miss.
Yes. And in Middle Stone Age, you can see knife, seeker. And in New Stone Age, tools use agricultural tools, no? Okay. And what is the appearance here? Proportionate and symmetrical in Old Stone Age. In Middle Stone Age, lightweight and durable tools. And New Stone Age, smooth and shiny finishing. No? In this way. We see here the tools used, their appearance, their uses, which technique they use. In Old Stone Age, percussion technique. In Middle Stone Age, fluted core technique. In New Stone Age, polishing technique. Huh? Here, some changes in man's lifestyles happened.
Oh, in yes, old, yes.
Yes. In Old Stone Age, they stayed in one place and built huts.
Yes,
yes, built huts and lived in groups, celebrated festivals, used the ornaments. Their lifestyles also changes in Old Stone Age to New Stone Age. In Middle Stone Age, they started the domesticating dogs, sheep, and goats, and started to harvesting the food grains and started eating plants food. And in New Stone Age, agriculture and animal husbandry became a mean of obtaining food. Hunting became a secondary. Now just with the help of this map, I shown you about Old Stone Age sites. New Stone Age sites. In Old Stone Age sites, places where tools were found, where that evidences are found. See, in Gangapur near the Nasik, Old Stone Age evidences found. In Chirki, Nevasa, near Nevasa. These both two places are in Maharashtra, Afghanistan, and Sri Lanka. And the Middle Stone Age evidences we found in Bangalore, in Rajasthan, Bhimbatek, in Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Langnash, in Gujarat, Patne, in Jalgaon. And New Stone Age evidences we found near the River Ganga and South India. See here in the map, that blue line indicates the River Ganga, so long. And down there, South India map also given. Okay. In this way, are you understood this lesson?
Yes, teacher.
Okay, now I give, here is a homework for you. Compare the tools from all the three periods of the Stone Age.
Stone Age.
Thank you very much, students.
Thank you, teacher.